Hi there, I'm Mick Wilson, and today we are looking at the Gary Levinson LS43 acoustic. For those of you that may recognize the name Gary Levinson, he's the man behind the Blade guitars, the electric Blade guitars. But he's produced acoustic guitars for quite some time, kind of alongside of that, but there's been a big push the last year to bring a whole new range of acoustics out. He felt that it was the time to do that. So this is one of them. It's a concert body guitar. I think there's about four in the range. Dreadnought, this is a concert. And we'll have a little look at it. From the headstock, we have a nice little flying fish logo in abalone there. That's something special to Gary. He's I think in his history, he studied marine biology or something, so that's his little thing there. And so we are looking at an ebony faceplate on there with the inlays around there, the edging around there. We have a bone nut there, and the fretboard is ebony, very nice fretboard, and the frets are kind of sort of medium size. They're very, very nice, easy to play. Working our way down, it's an Engelmann spruce top on here, and finished off at the bottom here with the bridge, which is also ebony with a bone compensated bridge on there. I had a little look kind of on the website about if there are any particular traits of this guitar, and there is one of the most important features that Levinson say about this is that the top has, it's voiced. They say it's a voicing top, and what that means actually is instead of it being, although it's a solid piece of material, instead of it being the same thickness all the way through, it's thicker and thinner in different places. And basically they wanted to achieve a very quick response. So they wanted this the top to move as quickly as possible to give us to give you the resonance and the volume as well. So in essence, I think it's thin around the edges, so there's less in contact with the body, so it can move a bit quicker. But around the kind of the middle area where it does shift, there's more mass there to give you even more volume on there as well. There's the bracing inside is also scalloped as well, so there's more bracing in certain places to give a little bit more movement there. And it is a very, very loud guitar. I've had it quite a while, and for the eagle-eyed viewer to this, I've used this a few times when I've been reviewing some other items and playing it. I really enjoy playing it, and it's just got a great sound. At the moment we're using it through the pickup. It's a Bags pickup in there, and it can come supplied with or without that, but that's a very, very fine pickup indeed, and seems to suit this guitar and gets the sound out of it. Okay, so flipping it over, we have the neck here, which is made of mahogany. It's one solid piece of mahogany, which is really nice. And the neck is kind of like a very shallow C, very sort of profile, which makes it very easy to use. I switch the gigs that I do, I switch between electric and acoustic, and this feels like an electric neck. It's, you know, one of these modern types, so it feels very, very easy to use. The machine heads, they're the butter bean style. They're proprietary to them. I don't know who manufactures those, but they work really well. Very, very fine adjustment on there, which is really nice, so you can kind of really get it into there. And the body is East Indian rosewood, which is really nice. It has that kind of nice sort of weighty sound to it. Even though it is a concert, I don't know if you can notice here, you probably can't tell because I haven't got another guitar with me, but this body is about almost an inch bigger than a regular concert. So it almost has that kind of high perkiness that a concert has, especially with the spruce top. But it has that weight as well because of the volume of the volume of it. And I say I've got a pickup in here at the moment, but it would have just a regular strap button if you didn't have that sort of pickup in here. The string length is I think around about sort of 24 3/4, so it's just slightly shorter than a regular Dreadnought, so that means you could probably use lighter strings, So you can sort of play very, very lightly. So what I'll do is that now I'll play something sort of quite light and then dig in. What I really like, which is, as I say, what they've set out to get, is this quick response so that you can kind of, it's balanced across the volume spectrum as well as the picking, so you can hear it picking, and then when you dig in, so it's not kind of boomy in any particular area. So you can hear that's nice and sort of light. And then if you want to really dig in, and I love that, it just feels as if it's kind of made for both of those purposes. You can be really delicate with it, and it really handles that as well. I don't know if there's some kind of, I know it's just wood and steel, but it feels like there's some kind of sort of compression thing happening there, which I really like, so you can really dig in, which is really nice. So that's kind of it really. We'll probably play a little bit more. I'll do something else for you with a microphone on it. I've really enjoyed playing it. I prefer the smaller guitars. It has that kind of sort of very sort of lively, springy kind of sound to it. But with this extra volume and the extra weight and the darkness of these woods actually sort of brings up, it's almost like adding a little bit of bass to the sound and sort of just evens it all out really. So there you have it, it's the Levinson LS43. Thank you.